Amen. من أسكن بيتك وأبقى مبقى فيه
and more than one thing. Our Namo Divine Nash Vishnu Sampadis, the Vishnu Sampadis, the Deans, our fathers, the priests, our brethren, the deacons, our fathers, the moms, and our fathers, the neighbors, for the 44 orders of Christians. That Christ our God may hold all this both in the paradise of glory, and we too have put mercy unto us, and forgive us all our sins.
Give us this day our daily bread,
and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. In Christ Jesus our Lord, who reigns and reigns in the power and the glory forever.
In Christ Jesus our Lord, amen, alleluia, and to you we ask you to sing to the glory. There are virgins that they also call the mother of Christ. Pray us, our God, of love and son, that he may forgive us our sins. Then to the Holy Virgin One, go forth our thoughts and to life, Christ our God.
Christ is our God, on our behalf, that he may forgive us our sins.
And forgive us our sins, all for the sins and all the sins of the Lord, the faithful and the faithful of all mankind.
Intercede on our behalf before our eyes, in the Lord, that he may grant us forgiveness of our sins.
Allah,
Jesus Christ, the King of Glory, is risen from the dead.
Alleluia, 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 Jesus Messiah, Malik al-Mulk.
أما من بين الأموال فالغربة مريض إنها يستمر أبدا رحمة البلاد في كل وربها
أما مريض إنها وزجنا بحمد الصمد
Jesus, Thank you. Amen.
يثبته على كرسيه سنين
وأنزلنا سلامية مديدة ويقطع جميع أعدائي تحت قدمي سريعا ويعطينا رحمة وحكمة في صلواتي. فاصنع من بشرات من ديني لمعلمنا مار محمد بشير التلميذ الطائر بركاتكم.
Comes in the name of the Lord, our Lord God, Savior and King of us all, Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, to whom is glory forever. Then Jesus spoke to them again, saying, I am the light of the world. He who follows me shall not walk in darkness, but have the light of the life. The Pharisees therefore said to him, You bear witness of yourself, your witness is not true. Jesus answered and said to them, Even if I bear witness of myself, my witness is true. For I know where I came from and where I am going, but you don't know where I came from and where I am going. You judge according to the flesh. I judge no one. And yet, if I do judge, my judgment is true, for I am not alone, but I am with the Father who sent me. It is also written in your law that is the testimony of two men is true. I am one who bears witness of myself, and the Father who sent me bears witness of me. Then they said to him, Where is your Father? Jesus answered, You know neither me nor my Father. If you had known me, you would have known my Father also. These words Jesus spoke to the testimony, and he taught in the temple, and no one laid hands on him, for his hour had not yet come.
أحببت أن يسمع الرب صوتك تدفعي لأنه أمال في سمعي إليا فنعطه في أيامي Amen.
Thank you.
Let us pray, our Father who art in heaven. Our Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son, and Logos of God the Father, who has broken every bond of our sins through his saving, life-giving suffering, who breathed into the face of his saintly disciples and the holy apostles and said to them, receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven. If you retain the sins of any, they are retained. Now also our Master, you have given grace through your holy apostles to those who for a time labor in the priesthood in your holy church, to forgive sin upon the earth and to bind and to loose every bond of iniquity. Now also we ask and treat your goodness, O lover of mankind, for your servant, my father, metropolitans and the bishop and father, and my brethren, and my weakness, those who bow their heads before your holy glory. Dispense to us your mercy and lose every bond of our sins. And if we have committed any sin against you, knowingly or unknowingly, or through anguish of heart, whether in deed or word, or from faint-heartedness, O Master, who know the weakness of men, as the good one and lover of mankind, O God, grant us the forgiveness of our sins. Bless us, purify us, absolve us, and all your people, fill us with your fear, and straighten us for your holy goodwill.
Of the vice, telling them that the bishop, and what
his grace, Bishop Joseph, Bishop of the Cathedral of Dr. Larissus of Namibia, Botswana, Zimbabwe, and Palermo. On Sunday, the 10th of March, 2024, at least the first of our Hat 17, 12:40 a.m., with the blessing and perfect choice of God, our beloved brother, who is full of spiritual virtues, even in the life of citizen, and aware of thoroughly with wisdom and management of all church and pastoral matter, Bishop Joseph. General Bishop was consecrated to be Bishop of Coptic Orthodox Diocese of Namibia, Botswana, Zimbabwe, and Malawi. At the great cathedral of San Amar, the West Cairo, Egypt, by laying my hand, I, Theodorus II, Pope of Alexander and Patriarch of Sicily and Mark, the 118th Pope of the Holy Apostolic Succession of San Mark, with the participation of the Metropolitan Bishops of the Holy Synod, who also in the presence of the abbots of the monasteries, whom they listed this choice and prayed to God, who the Holy Spirit upon this beloved brother. This choice has a sound of joy in all our hearts. In the presence of the Metropolitan and Bishop of the Holy Spirit, who participated with us, Bishop Joseph has been consecrated and has tasted the goodness of priesthood. He has the power of the Holy Spirit and the laying of hands on his mouth and by his hands to ordain priests and people by their different ranks to guide, care, and perform them account. He has the authority to consecrate churches, sanctuaries, altar, baptismal fonts, an icon as well as any altar utensil. He has the authority to bind and loose in every matter as a steward for God. He may also manage the affairs of the church within his diocese, as he is responsible for everyone's soul and the loss of their spirit. He acts wisely regarding their offering and gifts. He has the authority of stewardship over all his churches, pastorally, financially, and administratively, and may own church homes and hit them. He may set rules for his churches according to the word of God and the church tradition, and rules to ensure that things will grow continuously to the best. May peace and the apostolic grace be upon you, my blessed archpriests, priests, deacons, and all the congregation of this diocese that love Jesus Christ. God have answered your prayer, and now you have your own diocese with a new bishop, our beloved brother, His Grace Bishop Joseph. He is your father, chief, and judge, whom you dare to solve your problems and issues. You run to him for all your matters and affairs. You should offer him your love, give him your trust, listen to him, obey him in all what he guides you according to Christian law, which he utters secretly and publicly, because his lips preserve knowledge, and from his tongue you ask for the law, for he is the angel of the Lord of hosts and his apostle to you. Love, obey, and submit yourself to your bishop. Honor him as a father, as a chief from God, as the scriptures say, obey those who rule over you, and be submissive, for they watch out for your souls, as those who must give account. Let them do so with joy and not with grief, for that would be unprofitable for you. Also, as our Savior Jesus Christ said to his apostle, he who receives you receives me, and he received him with his help who sent him. He also said to his honored apostle, he who hears you hears me, and he who rejects you reject me, and he who rejects me rejects him who sent me. My blessed son, you shall accept him with perfect love and respect him as son to the father. You should recognize his spiritual honor which he had received. Do not listen any of your duties toward him. Remember to ask for him in your prayer and supplication before God. You should commit yourselves to attend the church, holy liturgies, and ceremony. Never renounce preventing yourself and participating in holy communion worship. You should never fail in the acts of mercy and offer your life first good and bad, for with such sacrifices God is with thee. We ask the blessing of our great shepherd, our Savior, our Lord, and our God, and our King Jesus Christ, to be upon you and your bishop, blessing before you the words of the saints, blessing the saints upon those who are weak. May your Holy Spirit, your whole spirit and soul and body be reserved blameless at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. May you grow in every spiritual knowledge and virtue with the intercession of our great, honored, blessed Lady Saint Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, and our honored martyrs and Mark, and all the ancient martyrs and saints, glory, honor, strength, and worship now and always and forever, our God. Amen. We, the delegates of the great Pope, His Holiness Pope John II, the 118th Pope of Alexandria, and the See of St. Mark, have enthroned our beloved brother, His Grace Bishop Joseph, on his throne, on this topic of those crises of Namibia, Botswana, Zimbabwe, and Malawi, and signed by His Holiness Pope Carlos and Metropolitan Daniel, and Bishop Thaddeus, and Bishop Nobel, and myself to work.
Yeah. وذلك كما بين المسيح الكبرى من ان الرئيس مع المسيح الطاهره وضع الذي نلى تولوت الثاني المدعو بابا الاسكندريه وبالنقل الكرازه القدسيه
الذي يرسلني يرسل الذين أرسلني. Thank you.
أجلسنا نيافة الأنبا جوزيف أسقفنا على سلام بنيان الكنيسة الله الواحد الوحيد المقدس الجامع
المسلم.
بارك المساء كلها
انا غرور بسيط صوت سيدنا ربنا خليك
Church for this blessed selection. Special thanks to our very honored fathers, our fathers, His Eminence Ambassador Serapio, Metropolitan of Los Angeles, Southern California and Hawaii, His Eminence Ambassador Daniel, Metropolitan of El Ma'adi, Basatin and Dar es Salaam, and Secretary of the Holy Synod of the Coptic Orthodox Church. His Grace Ambassador Raffius, Bishop of St. Bishoy Monastery in the Nitria Desert, Wadi Mafrur. His Grace Ambassador Lopez, Bishop of Shibin al-Manatir and its territory. We thank also Father Irwin Johanna Yakub from Cairo. The newly formed diocese is served by Blessed Fathers. In Namibia, Father John Wasky and Father Mark Mitri. Father Anthony in Botswana, Father Elia Antoni in Malawi, Father Michel Ramsey and Father Michael in Zimbabwe. Without further ado, I would like to call upon to welcome His Eminence Metropolitan Ambassador Serapio to give his speech. Your Eminence.
In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, one God, Amen, Socialist, and Protestant. On behalf of His Eminence, the Metropolitan Daniel, and the His Grace Bishop, Reagis, His Grace Bishop from there, and I wish to convey our sincere congratulations to the clergy and the senior congregation of the new diocese of Namibia, Malawi, and Malawi, for the support of you, Bishop, His Grace Bishop Joseph, pray that the Lord will give you the power to shepherd this new diocese as you served it before. And because we carry the prayer and the greeting congratulation of our Father, His Holiness Pope John II, who cared for all the church, bishop cared for Africa and the work of the our church in Africa, and of course establishing this new diocese. And also I wish to congratulate you to meet the congregation from the diocese of Los Angeles, the bishops, the Bishop Abraham, Bishop Jones, and all the clergy and the youth who came last year to join the service in the missionary. Yesterday I was in Johannesburg and I met His Eminence Metropolitan Antonius Moros, and he asked me to convey his congratulations to His Grace Bishop Joseph to all of you, and we all pray for him that to grant him good health and to remember his work to establish of the work of the church, not only in this area, but in all Africa, starting out Southern Africa and Sub-Saharan Africa. As he started in the 70s, he was the general bishop of African affairs in Kenya, extended the world and reaching all these countries which we see today. Establishment of a new diocese is a very joyous event. Installment of a new bishop is a great joy for all of us, especially when this diocese will be in Sub-Saharan Africa, in Southern Africa. Because Africa is the essential part of the main jurisdiction of the Bishop of Alexandria. If we go back to the 4th century in the Council of Nicaea, which we celebrate the 107th concept we've seen in this coming year, which was held in 325 E. They assigned the Patriarch King, the Bishop Patriarch King, and for the Patriarch of Alexandria, assigned the jurisdiction of Africa, all Africa. And so we think that is all the work of the Coptic Orthodox Church in Africa is in the light of the decision of the Council of Nicaea. And establishing of a new diocese is very important, because as we move from missionary work in this area, now the establishment of the diocese will deepen the pastoral care and even the work of the church in focusing on certain areas. And our church has spread the faith and then come to a certain region to be the diocese and to have a bishop to be taking care of this on this day. And this is the vision of His Holiness of Calvados that's moving up the steps of the Coptic Orthodox Church in sub-Saharan Africa to establish a diocese started by the diocese of South Africa with Mr. Poyet and Antonius Moros. Now is the second diocese which include this whole campus. And hopefully in the future, more and more diocese will be established in this area. As a guest official, Joseph is the right person to lead this diocese as the God granted him at being very comfortable with both good to the monastery. His monastic life in the Amishkoi monastery, I am pleased to be in the same monastery of his career. And he served there, and one of the work he got in the new host of the monastery is to take care of the monks really quickly. He was very famous for his love and his care. And we remember when we stand the doctors of Post Angus to build the monastery, and this woman, and not this place, is taking care. And this heart of love is the outcome of the close mission to God. Because as a monk grow in being with God more, it's hard to open to serve. So the people who go to the monastery is not because they want to be away from sitting, but they want to be close to God more, to be able to be open for the people more. And that's why as we grow the relationship with God, we grow and love is one another. And this is a good example of that. And then he was sent to serve. And he served because the priest, monk priest, you know, he served him, and then God chose him to be a general bishop for the establishment of this diocese, and now so to be the bishop of the diocese. And that shows that we have a new faith for the God of the servant to the member of the church, but also to the whole society. This society in India, the other countries, we have to come here to serve and to show love to everyone. And as we call it to be light of the world and the soul of the earth. So this diocese is our church is to serve the whole society and to be open to the needs of the society and to offer them the works of love. And as we more integrate in society, this is being a continuation of the church. So our church is not coming to serve the group who come to integrate, who come to work here, but also to serve the whole society and as we see, they serve in different areas, which is looking forward to my stay here to know more about this day. Also, this new diocese, not only for the benefit of the member of the church, this is for Canada, not only for the African society, this is for Canada, but also enrichment for the whole church. And we are thousands of miles away from living in California. But we feel the connection, we feel the benefit. And when we come here, like some of the groups which we sent last year, this was a great skill to enrich their life, their spiritual life, and also enrich our service. Because at the end, we are one church, at the end, we are one world. We all are human beings, whoever we are. So therefore, I'm looking forward to a close cooperation between the diocese of Namibia and Botswana, Zimbabwe, and Malawi, and our diocese which cover Southern California and Hawaii. And I hope that this cooperation will be for enrichment of both of the diocese. And this is how we can fulfill that this we are member.
The church has been serving in Africa for many and many years ago. But in 2019, God has called a Bonamon in one of the Nadron desert to serve his people. To Botswana was an invitation to serve. On the way, Father Enoch, his gracious old man, visited Metropolitan Amba Antonius Marcus in South Africa to take his lessons, and God arranged it that he advised him by saying, if you want to serve the African people, then you should wash their feet. As a symbol that this ministry should be full of humbleness, as Christ did with his disciples in the last Thursday supper. As an honest monk, he followed the advice and washed the feet of the whole village that we served there, which I can recall it now, it's named Damuchi. We first served on his first day of communion. People rejoiced. Heaven heard their prayers, and God accepted our prayers that he never leaves Africa. As we hear already in the enthronement document that says that with your prayers, he sends you him. And in Luke 1:15, but the angel said unto him, fear not the prayers, because the supplication is here, a prayer is here, and today we are rejoicing. This verse resembles and summarizes our dream in Namibia. As a servant, it was a dream that we thought it might not be happening that soon. But as Job 42 verse 2 says, I know that you can do everything and that no purpose of yours can be withheld from you. His wisdom, as his grace always says to us, being honest in a service, make sure that we'll add another service to you, because we are also precious in God's eyes. And in the enthronement document, we all hear fathers, metropolitans, and bishops, for while reading the commandment needed for, from his grace, and needed from us for this his grace as well. But I would like to highlight the verse that we read today in the enthronement document, which is Matthew 10:14. He also said to his order, apostles, he who hears you hears me, and who rejects you rejects me, and who rejects me rejects him who sent me. So we all have a responsibility to pray from all our hearts that may Lord bless our beloved bishop and the Joseph. For long years, full of wisdom, health, and we all tell him, we truly love you, Sayyidina. And at the end, we say the verse of Jeremiah 3, verse 15, and I will give you pastors according to my heart, which shall feed you with knowledge and understanding. And I would like to say the last part in Arabic, because that can carry all my feeling, I would say. And I say, إِنَّا بَفْتَحَ جِدًّا وَمُبَارَكْ بَيْنِي بَيْنِي أَكُونْ بِكْرِ سَمَدْنِ يَفْتَحْ وَيكُونْ مِلَادِي بِكَتَلُونَ هو إن أعلم من يفتح المحبة والخدمة والخير. وفعلا تلمذة وتعليم على إيدي يد الأنبا جوزيف بتحيي الإنسان من جديد بكل مرة. وفعلا يعطيكم راحة. شكرا جزيلا. Now, I would like to call His Excellency Ambassador of Egypt, Mr. Wael Gorfi, to give his address. We are gathered here tonight to celebrate a very special occasion to our lives. Indeed, the enthronement of His Greatness Ambassador as Roman Bishop for the Diocese is a marvelous occasion to reflect the great work of our beloved Egyptian Church and its achievement as a pillar for sustainable social and economic development. All and in Namibia, under the leadership of a great man such as there are many different monuments to record in the personal level when mentioning his face and my daughter. When I was appointed as ambassador to Namibia, and before arriving, he was among the first to call me to come. And when I arrived, he was the first one to be in courtesy. I call them made a big difference, because from that day on, we work hand in hand. Amba Joseph is a force of goodness, a force of kindness. And that's why we have been leaders. We have accomplished a few of them, and we are hoping for more to reach our goal of providing the media with sustainable development in social and economic fields. And we have a very ambitious project to do together with them all. And I hope one day we will be able to announce. I wish this place all the success and happiness. However, I do hope that it doesn't take further responsibilities and new responsibilities in other countries, because this portfolio is so big and we feel more and more. I wish you all the success. I wish our visiting group all the success, and I hope you enjoy your stay in India. And let me add a few words on the topic. Manawarin in India, Afaporin in Bhu, Afaporin in Bhu, we put us above our asana, and then around the father. What I can do in this, we have the funds, whatever we have in the media, we have to give them.
Thank you very much, Your Excellency. This place.
In the name of the Father, Son, the Holy Spirit, from God, Amen. Dear sisters and brothers, thank you all for being here with us today in this ceremony and the prayers. Your presence is very much appreciated. Special thanks and gratitude to my father and the brothers, His Eminence Ambassador Metropolitan of Los Angeles, Southern California and Hawaii, His Eminence Ambassador Metropolitan of Maadi, Pasadena and Dar es Salaam. Also, he is the Secretary of the Holy Synod of the Coptic Orthodox Church. His Grace Amba Arabius, Bishop of St. Bishoy Monastery in Nitria, Desert Wadi Nadron, Egypt. His Grace Amba Nofer, Bishop of Shibin al-Anatar and his dependencies. For their coming here, traveling far distance, may God reward them abundantly. I would like to acknowledge and thank my beloved brother, the Egyptian Ambassador, His Excellency Mr. Wahid Lutfi, Her Excellency Mrs. Melody, Ambassador of Zimbabwe, and His Excellency Consul of Russia, Mr. Max, and the representative, my brother's heads, and the representative of the church in Namibia, and my sisters, the blessed Catholic nuns, General Deputy Commissioners of the Namibia Correctional Service. I also acknowledge President and members of the Executive Committee of the Church Council of Namibia, CCN, acknowledging and thanking everyone of you personally, as you are also valuable to me. Also thank you to the members of media and the member of immigrations staff, either in downtown or the airport. Above all, I thank our loving and merciful God for entrusting me with this service. I am deeply grateful to our beloved Pope and Patriarch, His Holiness Pope Theodosius II, for his trust, as well as to all esteemed Metropolitan and Bishop of the Holy Synod of the Coptic Orthodox Church. It is an honor and a privilege to serve in this new established diocese spanning Namibia, Botswana, Zimbabwe, and Malawi. I am humbled by this opportunity and ask for your prayers, so that God may guide me by thy Holy Spirit. Let us have the teachings of our Lord Jesus Christ to serve rather to be servant, to wash the feet, not to dominate, to humble ourselves and remember those overlooked by society. May we strive to bring back the lost sheep and the prodigal sons. I am delighted that our service in Namibia extends behind pastoral and sacramental duties to include health care through medical missions and involvement with the Namibia Correctional Service and education institutions. We are doing visits and outreach programs to the NGO establishments, soup kitchen, elders, orphanage, disabled children, and homeless. Also, we intend to establish a vocational center in all varieties, TOT programs to teachers and nurses, programs for women and youth empowerment. With God's grace, I intend to expand all these activities and the program to the other three countries. Please pray that I may remain steadfast in my pursuit of the heavenly prize. Once again, I express my deepest gratitude to God and to all of you. Christ is risen. He is truly risen. Thank you. God's love.
His Grace, our enthroned Bishop, His Grace, and the Joseph would like to hand some souvenirs of the occasion. And we start with His Excellency, the Ambassador of Egypt, Ambassador Mr. Wael Morfi. Sister Oran, on behalf of the Catholic Church.
Thank you, Mom. You're welcome. Pray for me.
From the national.
Representative of the Egyptian community, Mr. Mohammed Omar.
His Eminence Metropolitan Abba Daniel.
I think we are all invited to come greet His Grace and have a chocolate.
Yeah, I can say it.